Welcome to my paper, 20th Century Malayalam Literature in English Translation. Core paper opted for BA English 3rd semester students. Today, we will be continuing with the Introduction to Malayalam Literature Part 2. So far, we have discussed about the history of Malayalam literature from the beginning to the end of 18th century. So in today's section, we will be looking at 19th century. After 18th century, literature has been taken in a more serious way. To say it is seen to be written, printed and with much more precision. Language of the common man and syntax of everyday communication are used to make it much popular and effective, which are adversely an impact of democratization or secularization of art forms or arts in general, thus paving way to modernity in the beginning of 19th century. So it is a crucial point of time in the history of Malayalam literature. And modernity marked the development of prose works in literature as a phenomenon resulting great social significance. With the rise and growth of social reforms movements like reformist work of Christian missionaries, their introduction of school system, which had a tremendous or immense effect on the socio-political fabrics of Malayalam literary world. Again, you have the advent of printed books, newspapers and journals, which you have already seen how it had an effect on British or English literary world. Likewise, or in the same way, it had affected the Malayali literary world too, in a positive way. Then there was the intrusion of the notion of everyday into the universe of literature, or an appeal towards the universal literature with everyday real life situations. This resulting in the evolution of new literary genres like novel, etc. So literature in general was getting into a more secularized or democratized way, as we have seen in the end of the 18th century. These all factors resulted in a growing notion of literary sensibility, with which an overall development of aesthetic, cultural and socio-political dynamics was at work in Malayalam literature. There were new idioms, new forms of literature as part of modernity. But you cannot omit the fact that there was an existing and ongoing tension between tradition and modernity as well. And the harbingers of the modern spirit, that is the persons who have signaled the coming of the modern spirit in Malayalam literature, were N. Kumaranashan, Ullur S. Parameshwar Iyer and Vallathol Narayana Menon. So they were trying to sort out or revamp tradition in their own way, that means in a new way. So the way they have expressed or the language they have used in a new way marked their modernity. And the new poetry was a blending or mixing up of both traditional and modern elements. So there was an intermingling, cross-fertilization of different elements. And they have taken materials or subjects from different sources like Puranas, epics, Kavyas and the most popular oral and folk narrative. So the new poetry was not a rejection of tradition, but a conscious effort to build tradition itself in a new way with a new perspective. They created a new reality, communicating their experience in and through the form of poetry. And when experience hit the surface of Malayalam language and literature, we have the romantic experience of poetry. A term used to describe the poetic sensibility found in early 20th century. It sounds romantic. Remember, it was not a replication of Western romantic poetry, but a more indigenized, elaborated version of Malayalam cultural ethos.
The romantic poets were G. Shankarakurup, P. Kunjiraman Nair, Edacheri Govindan Nair, Edappally Raghavan Pillai, Nalappattu Balamani Amma, Changampuzha Krishna Pillai and Vailopilli Sridhara Menon.
So what were the specialties of these romantic poets? They have used a new, indigenous, native kind of romantic writing. And they have experimented almost a varied number of themes, subject matters, and have employed formal convention. They have gone back to the formal way of writing. Next, we have a set of young poets of Romanticism who had at times shown a socialist or realist tendencies through their writings. And we have poets like P. Faskaran, Vailar Ramavarma, and O. N. V. Kurup.
and they have a political inflection, specifically to the left-wing politics, with a progressive spirit. So they extended a radical spirit of progressivism through their writings. Next we have modernism in Malayalam poetry. The term modernism was used to describe the poetry developed after 1950s. And it is anti-romantic in nature with deep irony. And it has used free verse and open forms of prose. Though it is poetry, it is written in the form of verse. And the poets of modernism are N.N. Kakkad, Ayyappa Panikkar, N.V. Krishna Varyar, Akkitham Achyuthan Nambudiri, Achur Ravi Verma, B. Sugathakumari and Vishnu Narayanan Nambudiri. And there was also this political concern of modernity. And we have writers or poets like Achur Ravi Verma, K. Sachidanandan, D. Vinayachandran, K. G. Shankarapillai, A. Ayyappan, etc. So the 1970s or 70s was a political decade for Malayalam poetry when we compare with the 1930s of the progressivism shown by the young poets of Romanticism. The age has witnessed heightened level of political activism, turbulent years for civil society in India, end of Nehruian era of liberal humanism and welfare economics, conflict between socialist and secular ideals, the emergency of 1975. These all resulted in the political activism of 1970s and 80s with heightened political sensibility, which clearly gets reflected in the different forms of literature of the modern era or the 20th century Malayalam literature.